Work assist means to choreograph. Dance is a fine art. The students learn technique from scratch. A lot of the students in this community never took a dance class before, so they learn how to count music, they learn how to do things as simple as point their toes. Eventually we get into what makes orchesis, which is student choreography. They learn the elements of choreography, which are based on space, time, and energy, how to use the stage space and patterns within that stage to tell a story, how to use the music as a backdrop to a theme. There's items about like motifs and how just one movement of a hand can start an entire idea. It's very based on literature, so they're really, there's a beginning, middle, and end. These pieces can range from being about the way a wet noodle moves, they can be about domestic abuse, which we've had some pretty powerful dances about that. They can just be very fun bachatas, they can be something as intense as a Japanese style of performance art that stemmed from victims of Hiroshima. There's a lot of contortionism, there's a wide range. And all they have to do is look around and pick something. Internally, or something that seems benign, and then they can create an entire theme from scratch. So the whole year is building not just technique, but what it means to choreograph a piece and what tools could be used to make something from in your brain to a full production with lights, costume, and tell a story from movement. In high school, orchesis was the one place where I felt most alive. Creating choreography and performing it on stage was a place of escape, and a place where I felt heard and seen more than anywhere else. Things happened at Illinois State. I became a math major and a dance minor. And then when they offered me my math contract, they also gave me the dance program with orchesis. Prior to me taking over, orchesis was a club where students would kind of pick their favorite song on the radio and just do a dance to it with no real talk of the elements of choreography, no real talk about modern technique, ballet technique, how to construct a piece based on a theme, motif, and so forth. Within 2 years, the club became a fine art because I held my standards very high. And then the students started to see by the end of the show that we actually put a piece of art together. My alumni to this day thank me for changing it. The students didn't realize what they were capable of until after they were pushed to their limits and they got to look back at a show that they were proud of and have for the rest of their lives to look back on. This school year, in my mind, began last March when we were first told that we're not going back to school. And everyone had this idea that this would be 2 weeks. Then when it started to not be that, my number one focus to my academic students and my dancers was mental health above all. I started to just offer videos and opportunities for them to participate as they felt they could. Finding joy was the hardest thing to do. They knew that dance was helpful, but just getting up to go to class was already so much of a weight. I started to make videos of very simple ways of stretching from sitting all day. Dance fitness videos that were a mix of kind of following along Zumba style, but also I had these little, I call them Grey's Anatomy breaks, where you just close your eyes and flop your arms around and just like get it out. And got it all out there in that way and offered up times for choreography. Fast forward, we don't know what the year's gonna bring. The summer was a blur for everybody. And then in August, there were still the same restrictions about in person, and I was given an opportunity to propose what a virtual year could look like. I wanted to give them an opportunity to be creative, to be able to just be reflective about dance, no pressure of a tryout or anything, just start that discussion. Art is needed now more than ever. I would come up with choreography workshops where we'd watch a video or two where they, sometimes there were mental health themes within that. I had a lot of non-dancers join that never tried out for me. That just became part of a discussion. And then we were able to just kind of analyze and start to create and go through all the motions of constructing a show where I am a one-on-one coach for choreography. We talk themes, I look for gaps in their story. It became a place where they could come to. There was definitely times, especially on the holidays, of some dropping off and picking back up and dropping off. I felt the same, I think, waves as my students, where we saw no end in sight. In person and virtual was always fluid. I think one of the coolest things was one of the dances that I showed. I really wasn't sure how it would be received. I didn't know what it was about. I just found it, kind of fast forwarded, looked at a little choreography in there and sent it for them to view. And I guess, especially with all the lack of things, my expectation was very much that they weren't gonna have anything to say or very little to say, and I'd really have to push the conversation. But they talked about how they felt like a lot of those dancers and they connected to the movement. I mean, they said these incredible things, like they have been working on dance and art their whole lives, and it was an unbelievable experience to see them open up to someone they really never met in person and discuss how that art really spoke to them and how that inspired them.
What were your thoughts? I saw you type in some really good stuff.
It really reminded me of like the 12 days of Christmas, because I started noticing, I was like, dang, this is really repetitive. And I started noticing that they're adding stuff in the beginning and then going through everything again. And that's what they kept doing. And I was like, that really does remind me of it. But it made me really confused of why they started taking off their clothes, because they went from like a white outstanding contrast shirt and then they put to a dull gray. And I was like, I can't really see them anymore. They're blending with the black background. And I was like, did they mean to do that? Or are they like, this mess up with coloring, you know?
Yeah, girl, you're speaking my language right now. It is important to notice. And it's the one of those things of what does that do to the audience's eye? Because so much of dance ends up being how we light the dancers. And costuming is kind of everything for that. Was there meaning behind black and white contrast with just the very stark white lighting? There's no gobos. It's just like, high, you're exposed. And then high, you're exposed more because you're taking clothes off. Really, it's never on accident. So like, why the gray? Like, did they want them all to blend in? Was it just the color choice or that they took their clothes off?
Both, because since it's such like a long repetitive dance, I don't know if that would be the best choice, because you're already starting to lose my focus from everything repeating so much and so fast, because I can't remember what they're doing other than like a couple outstanding like dance cues, like the guy falling, the guy going on the chair, or the back bend and stuff like that. But since they're taking all their clothes off and getting less noticeable, it's kind of like, do you want me to pay attention or do you not want me to pay attention anymore?
To what? The dance in general?
Yeah. It's like, it goes from like, I'm really invested in see what's going to build up to, but it's not building up to anything. So then I get kind of lost because I'm like, I know I have to keep watching this, but then I look and I'm like, there's still like a good 5 minutes left and it's kind of slowly losing my attention.
I got it.
And then when they took off their clothes, it's like, I can't see you guys much anymore.
So. I see. Interesting. Awesome thoughts. I would say the overall structure of this piece is something in the elements of choreography called an add-on. Sort of. I guess add-on is really what you see in, like, I'm trying to be hip like the kids right now. Like TikTok, if you have more than one person going, someone does part of the move, then the next person picks up where they left off. That's more of an add-on. This is repetitive, and it adds more to each piece of the story, and there's a reason for the repetitiveness, but there's a good discussion to be have about when is repetition effective, when is repetition just and I think you didn't say this, but you said in this in a way of like the audience's eyes get tired, like there were those things and we call them motifs. that the motifs that you picked out were ones that I'm sure most audience members would see. The throwing themselves back, dude jumping up in the chair, which Leslie mentioned too, and the dude falling. Like, those are the things that kind of tied us all back together. So maybe that's what they wanted us to notice, or really just those things, and the other stuff is just in it.
Yeah, because even with the guy that fell off, like, on the floor constantly, he wouldn't even take off any of his clothes, but he would do the action of taking off his clothes. Like, the shoe throw, he would sit in the chair, and once the people got up to throw their shoes, he'd pretend he's throwing his shoes, too.
Oh, dude, that's cool. I didn't even notice that. Did you have any thoughts or anything else that stood out to you?
At the ending, the guy that wouldn't rip off his clothes, he stayed laying down.
But this is effective. And it's that sense of, I'm not just connecting to the audience. It's like, I want you to pay attention. I'm staring you in the eye. You're hoping, this is one of the coolest things about dancing in front of people. And we're gonna be able to literally like record you looking right into a camera. That if you are able to, cause you can't see. If you've never performed on the stage before, the lights are in your eyes. But if you can find somebody to stare in their general direction, you just made them super vulnerable, and it's one of the most effective things. So they're doing all the stuff thrashing, and then they pause to stare at you. Oh my God. Like that.
I've done that plenty of times.
Oh yeah.
Made people cry. Yeah.
I know you have. I'm proud of you. She's made someone cry. It was awesome. Not in a beautiful.
No, like no, I'm terrified.
She was terrifying. She got a little girl to cry. It was amazing.
What that story made me think of.
Sure.
So I've been working in like an office for 3 years, different offices throughout 3 years. And what I kind of got from that dance alone was the repetitiveness of everyday life and
like
how you blend into a crowd so easily that you can't stand out. And the more you do, so like throughout the dance I kept adding on, but the more you do, the more stressed you become. That's why I thought they were taking off their clothes, the more, you know, flustered and aggravated they are with themselves and the people around them. And the one guy on the chair, he was trying to stand out a little bit more, and he kind of was getting like praise or something in like, in maybe let's say someone did a bunch of work and one person got more recognition than someone else. In my mind, I was thinking that. And then that one time when they stopped and stared at the crowd, it was kind of like a, hey, are you looking at me moment? Like, hey, you didn't realize I'm here kind of thing. That's kind of what I got from it.
Some dances can really hit you over the head with their theme, and they give you no room for interpretation. This one, I think, even if you know the meaning of the lyrics to this, it doesn't like ruin it for you. And I was actually surprised because I thought this was like a thing about the Jewish people. Like my question what that I thought they were screaming in with their movement was, what else do you want from me? Like I'm literally taking everything I've got and just they're chucking it. Like, what else do you want? Oh, you want this too? Like kind of the sickness of the what they've been going through for so long, being blamed for stuff. And then I got into like parallels of like, I'm sure the Black community, especially with this past year, could watch that and go, yeah, I get that. Like, what now? What, like, you're killed another one. Like, what else do you want from me? So I saw that, and then the articles I was reading, they're actually like talked about it being joyful, and I was like, whoa, okay. But this is the thing that was said: the illusion of beauty and the fine line between madness and sanity, the panic behind laughter and the coexistence of fatigue and elegance. It was really heady. But like, I was like, yeah, it's one of those things that you watch it. That's why it's good to have an initial reaction, then read up and be like, yeah, I guess I see that or I don't. And then, yeah, there's a bunch of stuff about what the Hebrew influence was in this, and that will be held for next time.
I try to validate too to my students, any change in routine can be jarring. This change in routine where you wake up, you get ready, and you're getting ready not just for school but for your extracurricular afterwards was pulled out from under them. The bare minimum was a lot, for a lot of them. They didn't have any normalcy whatsoever. I think being forced to be at home taught a lot of us how important the arts are, that that's the one escape we have when we feel trapped. The virtual experience of Orcasys gave them a chance to, even from far away, be an observer to what dance can be and what they are able to create from just their bedroom. I think TikTok did a lot of good things for dance, more than negative. TikTok made dance accessible. Non-dancers around the world started to learn dance to be part of a TikTok challenge. The drawback is that you don't get as much time to tell your story, but it also makes you tell your story in a concise way that's appealing to a greater audience. Dancers don't need space. You can dance large in the very small spaces. And when we were all confined to home during this pandemic and during quarantine, TikToks can be done anywhere, in a small space, in a bathroom, it can be done in the hallway. I think that was another huge reason it got bigger, is we didn't need a dance studio. You could do it anywhere. And then
such an ambition for you. And that's it. And then you just press stop. And that's it. Have fun.
Heaven sent you to me. I'm just hoping I don't repeat history. Boy, I'm trying to meet your mama on a Sunday, the nigga I love on a Monday. Never need no one else, babe, 'cause I'll be switching the positions for you.
To 2014 at the West Campus. I had the pleasure of also dancing alongside the most amazing people that I am still friends with to this day. Also, I had the pleasure of even graduating and then coming back and working at Westside in high school and also becoming a dance coach alongside Miss Stephanie Zapotello. Orcasys meant a lot to me. It was a family. It was not just a group of people who dance and twirl and jump up and down. No, it wasn't. It was so much more than that. It was about learning for yourself, growing as a person, and there was a lot of tears, a lot of laughs, and a lot of memories that I'll take for the rest of my life. Orcasys was everything when I was there, and I still have all those memories still locked up in the back of my head and always will. It was a great experience to learn so many new dances, so many new styles of dancing. and so many new life experiences. Thank you so much for the amazing experience and the memories. Orcasis was awesome.
Orcasis helps me in a way that brings out the outgoing side of me. I'm able to bond and get along with other peers. It gives me something to look forward to back in high school after a long school day. I love practices and performances because it brought out the creative and artistic side of me. The Orcasis group I got to know and work with was amazing, and I still keep in contact with them to this day. Ms. Zepp was a big part of me being able to find who I am and helped bring my confidence up through dance. I had a hard time back then with family and school, but Orcasis was my rock that I can go to and dance my problems away. It really helped me clear my mind and I focused on what was happening in the present.
Oh, One piece of advice that I have for graduates is never stop believing in yourself and always follow your dreams, because you will make it happen. Even if there's struggles along the way, you have the power to push through.
Hi everyone, this is Ariana from class of 2015. Just wishing the class of 2021 a happy graduation. Thank you so much for, you know, being a part of Orcasys and, you know, continuing the amazingness, the creativity, the fine arts of it all, and the choreography of Orcasys, and, you know, being able to be a part of the alumni like me and always come back and support, you know, Zep and everybody. My advice for you guys would be to relax, take a deep breath, slow and steady wins the race. And if you guys do continue to further your education for college, my advice would be to be involved, whether that be joining clubs, honor societies, Greek life, anything to make your college experience a lot more worthy. Or not worthy, but more like memorable, you know? Well, anyways, this is me, class of 2015, Ariana, signing out. Bye.
Hi guys, my name is Jackie and I'm here to wish the graduating seniors class of 2021 a big congratulations. You guys deserve this. Let's just start off by saying that. And whatever your journey was to get here, just know that it was well deserved. And you have nothing but endless and great opportunities ahead of you. Whether these next 4 years bring you college, whether you're working, or you're traveling, or whatever you have in store for yourself, just know that all you have to do is believe in yourself. That's my advice. My advice would be just to really believe in yourself. I'll be honest, I've been out of college for almost 2 years and I'm still trying to get my life together. It's okay. It's okay not to know what your next step is. It's okay not to know this is what you want to do the next 4 years or your entire life. It's okay. Things happen. But just ultimately really believe in yourself and truly know that the universe has something in store for you and it's planned. And whether you may not know it, but you will, I promise you, in 3-4 years from now, you will really understand that the universe had this in store for you and everything happens for a reason. Really believe in yourself, love yourself, and just know that you can do anything that you set your mind to. Bye guys.
Hello, my wonderful Orcasys seniors. Congratulations for having made it this far. Hey. I don't know if any of you really know me, but my name is Caesar and I am an Orcasys alum. Zep reached out to me now that it's been a couple years since I've been on Orcasys. Not too many years, but a couple years. Hoping that I had some advice to share, and I thought about it. And I guess I wanted to share with you that dancing is not that easy to come by. After graduating Leiden, you know, we think we took for granted that Zepetello offered us a space where we can dance and where we can express ourselves creatively, but that doesn't really exist out in the wild, just like naturally. You have to actually go out and seek those opportunities. And, you know, there's plenty of options now. Many of you are going to universities and colleges, and they're going to have clubs that offer dance for sure. Or there are online workshops and tutorials and all that good stuff now. But my point is, it doesn't really just come to you. You have to go out and find it. So that's my official advice to you, to make the effort to actually go out and explore the opportunities of dance, especially now that you're leaving high school. You'll realize that there are just so many things about dance that you just don't know yet, and you can't know until you go look for it. So I really do encourage you to go out there, do some exploring, and that you continue to enjoy dance. Congratulations again.
Congratulations, 2021 graduates. My piece of advice would be to work your butt off, but make sure you continue to do things you love, because life can get crazy, a little bit wacky, and you always want to make sure you're making yourself happy.
Much love.